did a comedian and a pizza CEO turned politician become one?
Anybody who shares my values can show it by voting for Herman Cain.
It's the latest Stephen Colbert caper, even more cunning than his decision to explore his own possible candidacy.
For the president of the United States of South Carolina, I'm doing it!
But how to get on the ballot? Problem. It's too late for Stephen Colbert to get on the South Carolina ballot, and write-ins aren't allowed. Solution. Herman Cain is already on the ballot, though he's dropped out of the race. So take his place.
There is one name on the ballot that stands for true Americaninity. Herman Cain.
Colbert's Super PAC produced a Vote Herman Cain commercial, and Colbert used his show to exhort fans and young people of the internet to
tell the world how much you love Herman Cain.
South Carolina has an open primary, so Democrats and independents could vote for Cain, and Colbert-friendly websites were buzzing with Colbert-Cain fever. So could the fake commentator impact South Carolina's real primary?
Short answer is no. We may see a bump. But I think the serious point is that sometimes it takes satire to tell the truth in a really spin-saturated world.
Colbert got a chilly reception when he appeared on video at what was billed as a Cafe Mom town hall.
Mom?
Full of South Carolinian mothers.
How many of you want him to run? Applaud. How many of you don't want him to run? Applaud.
He's rude. He mocks.
But another mom said she never knew what a super PAC was till she watched the Colbert Report satirizing super PACs. For the uninitiated, comedians like Colbert,
they become the gateway drug to politics.
We wondered what Herman Cain thinks about Colbert stealing his electoral identity, but he didn't return our calls. Remember what Cain said the day he dropped out of the presidential race?
I am not going to be silenced, and I am not going away.
He's not going away if Stephen Colbert can help it.
Send them a message. Vote Herman Cain.
May the best smile win. Make that the slowest. I am America. Jeanne Moos, CNN, New York. To heal